championships that we love to talk about in the Bronx, we never had anywhere to show off the memorabilia. So here in the new stadium, we finally do it. And we rotate the displays every year or so to keep them fresh, but they all seem to come back to the same theme in one way or another, and that's the great teams that we have had over the years and the players who made them special. So here we talk about five great Yankee teams. First one, 1927, was, according to most experts, Babe Ruth's greatest season. He hit 60 home runs, which was a new record, broke his own record. The record before was 59, and that was also Ruth from the year before. But more impressive than breaking his own record, he hit more home runs than any other team. So there's 25 players on the team, and no team in the league had more than 58 home runs. He had 60 all by himself. And then there were five other future Hall of Famers on that team, so you can imagine how easy it was for them to walk away with that pennant. And so for 2 years, 27, we swear, not only were they there, they were all in right field where the ball landed and almost got a hand on that ball. The guy who caught it was a 19-year-old kid who jumped up on the seat and grabbed the ball barehanded. So we know where it went, but it's amazing how many people had their hands on it before that kid grabbed it. 1977 ended a bit of a drought for the Yankees. In New York, what we consider a drought and what people in Chicago or Boston even consider a drought is much different. 10, 15 years here is an eternity. In Chicago, 100 years, they're still waiting. So they don't have any patience when we talk about it. They just don't understand why we get upset. But this was a 15-year drought. I'm very fond of them. Their manager happens to be a former Yankee guy named Don Mattingly. He's a big favorite of the Yankee fans, so we kind of tolerate them now, but we really don't like them. 98, the middle of a five-year stretch. The Yankees actually won 4 out of 5 from 96 to 2000. 98 was the single best season of the five. Actually, it was the single best season ever for a Yankee team. They won 125 games and lost only 50. So, our most recent string of championships, but also the single best season in Yankees history. Number two, if you've been in New York for more than a half an hour, you've seen at least 10 or 20 number two jerseys walking around the streets. That's Mr. Jeter. He's the unofficial mayor of New York, the face of the Yankees for the last 20 years. Mariano Rivera, number 42, the greatest closer of all time. And then another handful of players. We have the string, and we have five or six great names there. Jeter, Mariano, Pettit, Posada, Bernie Williams, all household Yankee names. You guys all together?
Yes.
Yes, where are you from?
Most of us from New Jersey, some of us from New York. No mix.
No mix.
That's a mix.
We say mutts.
But so we know we
need to get the benefit of that. So yeah, I mean, you should know the folklore already,
right?
We talked briefly, of course, about Ruth and Garrick in 27, DiMaggio.
David Wells.
It's a perfect game. On May 17, 1998.
Must be nothing, yeah.
It was Billy Baby Day.
Yeah.
I thought they were for a couple
of things. It's
while we're in here. The uniforms and the baseballs are fake.
Is everything real? The batch and
everything?
Yes. It's
fake.
No, there's no replicas. It's all
just making sure.
That's the good stuff, yeah. We even have some bubble gum over there, 65-year-old bubble gum.
Wow.
There's a, you see that championship ring display? 26 rings, one pocket watch. 40 World Series competitions, 27 victories. So with a record of 27 and 13, we've lost more than anybody else has won. It actually takes the next three teams to equal the Yankees' record in World Series. Cardinals have 11, the Giants have 9, and the Athletics have 8. That's 28, the Yankees have 27 by the Sox. So, we don't worry about anybody catching up, we're good. But we are cranky when they don't win. We are spoiled. I was telling the folks who were here on time about Chicago and their idea of a drought and our idea of a drought, a little bit different. The Cubs have been waiting since 1908, and we're waiting since 2009. So there's a little bit of difference.
Good job, Jamie. Thanks a lot, bud. You're here 2 seconds. People are trying to have a good time. Can we just get him out, please?
Quiero saber lo del Vini Baby, preguntémoslo.
Preguntancia, es muy no me parece interesante.
Hey George, Simon and I had a tour full of people who were half asleep.
Sin esta gente, se estaba.
Eran de antes.
This of course is Yogi, a little respect. Yogi. The record holder for most world championships, 10 World Series championships.
Yep.
In 18 seasons, he played 14 World Series and won 10. So a record holder, a great ambassador for baseball, a real figure of the game. Unfortunately, he passed away about a week ago. Today was his funeral. He passed away at the age of 90. And in the middle of the process to receive the Presidential Medal of Freedom, which is the highest civilian award an American can receive. The first step was to present a petition to the White House with 100,000 signatures. They reached 120 and sent it in to get it. One goes for auction. I've seen DiMaggio under 1,000.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Because he's expecting a lot more.
Well, he did a lot of signings, you know, shows and things like that in his later years. The roof we have here is beautiful. It's a 10. All the compartments, the signature is great. It's on loan.
It's on loan.
But I've seen a couple that were much worse condition go for 30 and 40 pounds.
The roof over there, it's in great condition. We've seen worse ones go for 30, 40 Gs. Where's that?
Where's the roof?
16 would be, or C.
Where is it?
How long
has this been?
Yeah, thanks.
It's
just above the
Mattingly.
Could you not
begin
it? You can't help it.
I love you.
That's fucking funny.
I do it to him.
I didn't ask.
I know. I don't know. He's taking business for everyone.
We got a lot of them.
I know you're quite a lot of people.
Esta es la réplica de supuestamente el lanzamiento en esa ocasión.
Y ya no es este que yo ni lo vi.
Es un cacho.
Pero con fluorescente.
Which ones do you think are the best seats?
There's best and best value.
Uh-huh.
The best seats cost $1,500, so they're not the best value. If you go up here and you look straight ahead, right behind home plate on field level, those seats are $1,500 a piece. That's like a month's rent for most people.
Yeah.
If you go one level up, they're $250, and it's a better view.
Wow.
But you don't get all the free food. But for $1,250, you can buy a lot of food for some price. So I would go upstairs five times rather than one downstairs if I had that kind of food. I don't do either one.
Interesting.
You can get $25 seats right here, just don't wear a Boston jersey.
What is this, black?
There's always one. Every time Boston comes to town, this is where the Bleacher Creatures are. These guys are here every day.
Yeah.
They're more or less tanked before they get here. And this is their turf.
Right.
Why you would come all the way from Boston, put on a shirt, sit in there, and yell nasty things at Derek Jeter. And not expect to get beat up.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't understand it. It happens every time they're here. Somebody will get on one of the Yankee players with an Ortiz jersey. And then when he gets doused in beer...
He wanted his life.
Yeah.
I was at Shea for the second interleague game at Shea. And it was pretty nasty.
with us?
There was
it's like inner family, you know.
Yeah, but
we can beat them up. We don't want anybody.
Exactly, but there was a guy there with young, two young daughter and a friend,
well,
and the usher had to come over and tell these other guys, look, you need to clean it up or you're gonna have to.
But that's dumb too. Anyway, getting back to the Yankees. The numbers here are retired, meaning nobody wears them anymore for the Yankees, and these are the greatest players ever to wear the Yankees uniform. Starts in the 1920s with Lou Gehrig and Babe Ruth and runs through the years. DiMaggio and Mantle and Herman Munson and Reggie and Mattingly and the great stars. We've actually run out of space here and started working on the outside wall. Space for three more over here, and then we're really in trouble. Say again?
Number two's
not here yet. Next year, when we need a full house, we'll have
only a single number.
Yeah.
Va a estar dos años después.
Number eight, the only one.
Number eight is twice. I'm 42. Robinson and Marianne. So the whole tradition began with these three stones. First one went up in 1932, and then you see 41 and 49. These were the first three great, great Yankee figures. One was a manager, Miller Huggins. The other two, the greatest players ever. And when before the stadium was renovated in the 1970s, all of this would have been part of the playing field, and these things were in play.
Yeah.
So conceivably, you could hit a ball that would land behind there and cause all sorts of havoc. But it was so far away that it didn't happen very often. Maybe once or twice a year a ball would get through. Never over. It was just too far. But every once in a while a lucky ball would get through there and cause a lot of confusion. By the time they got the ball out, brought it back, and threw it in, people were running like crazy. It was pretty exciting. But that was the case until 1973. They closed the stadium for 2 years, 74 and 75, to be remodeled. And they brought the fences in from a little bit further than that back wall to about here. And that's all the difference in the world. Now all of a sudden you can reach it. So they made a garden that housed these two monuments, and there were a couple of plaques by that time. But over the years it grew and grew and got pretty crowded. So coming to the new ballpark, we laid out what we thought was plenty of room, but we've already filled that up. So I'm not sure where we're going to go. When I have room for three here, and as the gentleman said, number two is sure to go up. It's just a matter of when we decide to do it. So we have room for two more players to show themselves worthy of being on the wall. Then we have a real problem. Stay close to this. At this point, it's hard for me to make sure everybody gets to the ball.
Yeah,
they just want to see if they can catch me.
Yeah.
They're playing stump the tour guide.
Yeah.
But that's not fair either. If you have any questions, come here. If you want a picture taken, it'd be great to do it.
Did you ever meet George Steinbrenner?
I shook his hand once, just in passing. I was coming to work and he was leaving. He would never have remembered it, you know. And we didn't have much of a conversation, just how you doing, and keep going. I did get to meet some of the older players and the new guys. The new guys, again, it's just more or less running into them in the hall and maybe have a couple of minutes, you know. But some of the older players I've gotten to know pretty well, which is fun. The guys I grew up watching, you know, I like talking to those guys. So, would you like a picture together?
Oh yeah, please, with your phone.
Woo!
Wow.
Yeah.
Hey, can I take a look at it?
Sure.
Touch it.
Oh, you got a bow.
Sure, I got a bow.
Legend. Yeah. What did you just yell out and say, can you get me one? Can
I hit it and I said, you know, my big mouth up and it finally worked.
Nice.
It just gets me in trouble.
Oh, I almost had that.
Come on, I'll leave the tape for you.
Throw it up there. Hey, take it here.
Set him in the poor target.
That's the Boston
Farm
system.
Boston Farm system. No, I'm sorry.
Some dirt from the Yankee infield.
Wow. time today, right?
First stop. Over here, all right. Left, please, in here.
Darn, I wanted to go there.
That's why we got you over here.
Yeah. I hate these rules.
Rules is rules. That's for you.
Oh, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Hey, Maho, take me a picture with him, please.
You already got one. What more do you want?
I want another one.
He just delivered this one. Let's take a picture.
A ver, tómate una.
Come on.
He has waited 22 years for this moment.
Yeah. Really?
He was
first time here.
The first time here. First time. Give me that back.
Since he was 8.
This is from the old Yankee Stadium.
Okay.
This is the outfield wall.
Oh yeah.
Take that home too.
Oh come on. Oh, thank you.
Thanks so much.
My pleasure.
San Diego va a estar feliz, lo vamos a traer. Qué emoción, ¿verdad? Yo ya tengo hambre, voy a tomar unas salitas y... ¿Cómo te sientes de estar aquí? ¿Quieres unas palabras para San Diego?
gana?
Entre 50 y 100 al año. Bueno, más, tal vez más.
Sí. Pues son gachos.
Sí. Es que estos no son gachos. Si están aquí es porque ya son grandes ligas. Aquí nadie gacho. Ellos estarán en 200 al año, ¿sabes? Los gachos están en Tampa entrenando. El equipo son 25 jugadores. O sea, cuando juegan son 9, pero el equipo son 25. Y cuando es postemporada son 40. No sé si ahorita ya hay 40, yo creo que ya hay 40, pero sale un montón porque ya se está terminando la temporada. Al final de la temporada, en vez de 25, suben a 40 la cantidad de jugadores. Para que los que tienen potencial, pero todavía no son grandes ligas, puedan venir a testear las grandes ligas. Así no entran tan en frío. Todavía falta la práctica de bateo a los Red Sox. Te das cuenta que todos están entrenando, mira. El que está allá en la primera base está entrenando mientras estos batean, mira. Entonces muchas veces cada bateador trabaja una mecánica específica de bateo. Le pide que le tiren un tipo de lanzamiento porque quiere practicar ese. Por eso muchas veces salen hacia el mismo lugar, hacia la misma banda, mira. Todas están saliendo para allá, viste. Como que está bateando para la banda contraria. Hace un ajuste y después le empieza a ganar y tal vez todos caen acá. Eso es lo que ellos practican antes de cada juego. Por ejemplo, si el pitcher de hoy sabe... Si el pitcher de hoy tiene un lanzamiento especial, le piden que les tiren ese lanzamiento al entrenador. Y antes hacen eso que se llama toque, mira, y creo que lo hacen para reconocer cómo está tirando. Otro zurdo, a lo mejor la jala. Yo creo que ahorita todos están practicando a la banda contraria, fíjate. Oh, where's this coming from? Oh,
one of the pitchers gave it to me.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Thank you. I was
there you go. I was explaining here. There is now the 40-man roster. Right?
Yeah, I don't know who hit these guys off.
Yeah.
This is Severino. This is our new great pitcher.
Oh yeah, is this Severino?
This is him here, I think.
Yeah. Because there is a lot of people. That's what I thought.
Yeah.
It must be the 40 roster, 40-man roster.
Yeah, it is. And these are mostly pitchers.
Yeah, I heard that Mariano Rivera used to like to.
Yeah, he used to do this all the time. He got hurt doing it.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Mariano, he
tore up his knee. Watching these guys do it gives me nightmares.
I know.
Well, they're
young,
they're
20 years old.
Estoy tan emocionada.
Esto es lo
máximo.
Yeah, because I am a fan since I am 8 years old when I started to play baseball. I am a left-handed. I was pitcher. I am lefty, and my team
left-handed too. That's why we like.
Oh, yeah, that's great. Yeah, my team was the Manhattan Yankees back there in Guatemala, so
nice.
Therefore I was raised as a Yankee fan.
Yeah, you gotta wait for the lefties. Once the lefties get up, they'll be out here.
Seems like they are practicing the opposite.
Yeah, they're pulling the ball. There you go.
There it is. Whoa!
Luis!
Si
pasan
de una edad ya los quitan.
Sí. Es lo que estoy diciendo, que aquí todos casi tienen 20 años de edad.
¿Y a los cuántos los quitan?
Hasta que se retiran.
Seguro. O el de ayer, uno de ellos.
Diego, qué emoción. emoción, que tengo una pelota. ¡Ay, ay, ay!
Venga, venga, venga.
Como tira Tanaka.
Como el panameño. Era panameño, va.
So who's hitting that?
That one I recognize.
sí, una mejor oferta, $12 y trae tres hamburguesitas, pueden ser de pollo o de carne y papitas. Está mejor porque hay una de $20 y trae cinco hamburguesitas de pollo o de carne, pero cinco es mucho.
Perdón, no te estoy poniendo atención, ma. Aquí es donde el señor aquel dijo que, ¿cómo se llama? Que me dio la bola.
Richie,
aquí fue donde él dijo que es el mejor lugar. Pues de aquí valen mil no sé cuántos dólares, esos valen 300. Aquí es donde yo me quería sentar, $300 cada uno. Es una vista preciosa, mira. ¿Quieres sentarte? Podemos estar aquí hasta que vengan los dueños de los sillones. Han de ser estafa, acuérdate que adentro hay un montón de medios de comunicación buscando entrevistas y cosas así.
Y los que están aquí sentados con unas libretas cuando empezamos a bajar.
A ver. No sé. ¿Cómo va? Es increíble. ¡Cómo viaja la bola, por Dios! ¿Tusca? Tal vez hay un wifi, no creo que haya.